फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। यू कैन सर्च माय ऑल द वीडियोस बाय टाइपिंग प्रवीनेश पब्लिकेशन ऑन यूट्यूब। इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट देन यू कैन व्हाट्सएप मी ऑन माय नंबर एंड दैट इज 9016487991। इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट देन यू कैन व्हाट्सएप मी ऑन माय नंबर दैट इज 9016487991। फ्रेंड्स, watch my all the videos till end, and if you like the videos then subscribe it and share it. Please press the yellow button and also press the bell icon so you will get all the updates. Today I am going to explain standard 10 science in the chemistry chapter number 2, that is acid, base and salt. Friends, we know what are acids, we know what are base and what are salt, that is from our previous standards. We understood this three term from 7th standard. I will write some examples on the board. For example, citric acid. Have you seen citric acid? Some of the students say yes, we have seen the citric acid. Then after, oxalic acid. Then after, malic acid. Then after, tartaric acid, lactic acid, acetic acid. Friends, I have written name of some acid on the board. First is citric acid, oxalic acid, malic acid, tartaric acid, lactic acid and acetic acid. If I ask you question, have you seen all this acid? Some of the student will say yes, we have seen, and some of will say no, we have not seen this acid. Friends, I'll tell you, this all acids are present at our home, but in hidden form. Hidden form means what? They are in our vegetables. For example, citric acid present in lemon, oxalic acid present in green leafy vegetables, malic acid is present in apple, tartaric acid present in tamarind or grapes, lactic acid is present in milk and acetic acid is present in vinegar. Friends, we are using vinegar for making Chinese foods. So these are the example of some acid. Friends, we discussed about acid, base and salt in this chapter. Let us understand in detail. Now friends, first difference between acid and base. Acids are sour in taste, while base are bitter in taste. Acid turns blue litmus paper into red, and base turns red litmus paper into blue. Here friends, what is litmus paper? Litmus is a natural extract we are obtained from the lichens. It is in solution form as well as in paper form. There are two types of litmus paper that you can see on your screen. Blue litmus paper as well as red litmus paper. If you dip litmus paper, that is blue litmus paper, into acid, so it will changes to red in color. And if you dip red litmus paper into base, so that changes into blue in color. Next, acid gives H plus ions on ionization. Here friends, H plus ion, existence of H plus ion is not possible. They are in the form of H3O plus ion. H3O plus, that is hydronium ion. We will take information about this hydronium ion in detail in later section. Base, they give OH minus ions on ionization. So this is the main difference between acid and base. Friends, we know that acids are corrosive. they create some harmful effect on our screen. So same as rays are also create some harmful effect on our skin. Examples are in acid, hydrochloric acid, H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid, lactic acid, etc. Examples of base are NaOH, KOH, etc. So this is the difference between acid and base. Now friends, we understand classification of acids. Friends, I will write some example of acids here. HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid, H3PO4, so that is phosphoric acid. You can see here, we have only one hydrogen, here two hydrogen, and here in this we have a three hydrogen. So on the basis of the number of hydrogen, we can classify the acid. This is called monoprotic acid. This is diprotic acid. And this is triprotic acid. Friends, what is monoprotic acid, what is diprotic acid, and what is triprotic acid? Monoprotic acid means if it gives only one hydrogen on ionization or only one hydronium ion, so that is known as monoprotic. Mono, that is single. In H2SO4, you can see it gives two hydrogen ion on ionization, so that's why it is diprotic. In phosphoric acid, it gives three hydrogen ion, so that is triprotic acid. So this is the basic classification, or we can say that the first classification of acid. Now next type of classification, friends, acids are classified as organic acid and inorganic acid. Friend, organic acid, they are the weak or mild acids. Inorganic, they are strong acids. Organic acid that we can drink, that we can take or consume as a food, they are obtained from the vegetables. For example, citric acid, oxalic acid, tartaric acid, lactic acid, etc. On the other hand, in inorganic acid, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, so these are the strong, that is inorganic acid, and they are purely chemicals and that we cannot consume. So this is the second level of classification of acid. In that one we have an organic acid, that is weak or mild acid, and that we can consume as a food. Example, citric acid, oxalic acid, tartaric acid and lactic acid. On the other hand, inorganic acid, they are the strong acid, hydrochloric acid, H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid, H3PO4, that is phosphoric acid, that we cannot consume as they do some harmful effect on our skin as well as in our body if we consume it. Now friends, classification of base. I'll write some example of base here, that is NaOH, CaOH twice, and AlOH thrice. We know that the base give OH minus ion. You can see that here only one OH is present in NaOH, so it can give only one OH minus on ionization. So this is known as monoprotic base. Here in CaOH twice, it can give two OH minus ion on ionization. So it is known as diprotic base. And in aluminium hydroxide, it can give 3 OH minus, so it is known as triprotic base. So this is the first level of classification in base. Now we will understand the second level of classification of base, that is strong base and mild base. Now friends, strong base and mild base, that is also known as weak base. Example of strong base, that is KOH, NaOH and CaOH twice. You can see that the metal component K, that is potassium, Na, that is sodium, Ca, that is calcium, they are highly reactive metals and they give more OH minus ions, so they are known as strong base. Mild base, so these are the less reactive metals than K, Na and Ca and they give less OH minus ion on ionization, so these are known as weak base or mild base. Friends, here the number of OH minus ion is not a matter. You can see here only one OH minus and here three OH minus, so it can give more OH minus, no. But when we dilute them in the water, according to the reactivity, they will give you more OH minus ion, so that's why they are strong base. So this is a classification of acid and base. You need to memorize all the things. You will not get this thing in your textbook, but this will be helpful for your further topic. Now friends, next topic, that is indicator. What is the meaning of indicator? Whether the given solution is acidic or basic, that we can get the knowledge with the help of indicators. There are two types of indicator, natural indicator and artificial indicator. First, in natural indicator, we discuss about the litmus. We already understood, in litmus, we have a red litmus paper and the blue litmus paper. Blue litmus paper turns red in case of acid and red litmus paper turns blue in case of base. So if you dip a litmus paper into solution, blue litmus paper turns red, so that is acid, and red litmus paper turns blue, so that is base. Next example of natural indicators are clove, vanilla extract and onion. Friends, here by litmus, we can get the nature of the solution, whether it is acidic or basic, by the color change. But here, by the smell, we can check the given solution is acidic or basic. So these are known as olfactory indicators. Friends, how can we check the given solution is acidic or basic with the help of onion? Take a cloth strip, chopped onion. Put this cloth strip into chopped onion overnight in a freezer. Early in the morning, take out this cloth strip and wash it with the plenty of water. At this time, you can get the smell of onion because the smell of onion is very strong. Now, put this strip into a solution. If you get the smell again, so that is acidic solution. And if the smell is removed or you can't get the smell of that onion, so that is basic solution. Friends, we eat food at night. Our mouth pH, what is pH that I will discuss later? pH, that is power of hydrogen, or we can say that is the scale for the acidic, basic and neutral solution. In mouth, our pH is 5.4, normal range of the mouth pH is 5.4. When you eat sugar kind substances, it lowers your mouth pH and you will get some bacteria in your mouth, and due to this bacteria that occur a bad smell. So what we will do, we will apply toothpaste. We do the brush or toothbrush in the morning. So we apply this toothpaste. This toothpaste is basic in nature. So whenever we eat food which contains onion, so then after we wash the mouth with base, that is any toothpaste. So these are the olfactory indicators. Now on the other hand, we have a artificial indicator. In artificial indicator, first example is phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein is a clear transparent solution. When you add phenolphthalein into basic solution, so that base will turn into pink color. And if you add phenolphthalein into acid solution, so there is no color. So with the help of phenolphthalein, we can say that the given solution is acidic or basic. Next is methyl orange. Friends, methyl orange is orange in color. If you add into base, so that base turns into yellow color. And if you add into acid, that turns into red color. That you can see on your screen, the effect of methyl orange, that is artificial indicator on acid and base solution. So here friends, we understood basic concept of acid, base and salt chapter. Now read first 2-3 pages of this chapter. If you like this video, then please press the bell icon and subscribe the channel. If you have any doubt, then you can contact me on my number, that is WhatsApp number, that is 9016487991.